Hey guys, your boy Crippers, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Olympic Marseille Chrome, where we're last time left off. The second team infuriated me once again by once again not doing their job properly. Just poor performance after poor performance. Luckily, I have two straight games with the second team. With the main team before I play with the second team in the Europa League again. Luckily, all I need to do is win that Europa League match somehow, some way, and then my focus can be turned to the knockout stages of the Europa League in the new year. By which point I will have significantly improved with the second team.
Marseille.
Now I know exactly how I'm going to do it as well. Well, they've got some good individuals. Also, in the last episode, this also got great team, the main team, back line. Won the first League Cup game.
And we put it out here, Alan, as a 4-4-2. Would you go along with that?
Yeah, I think with those of you who know your French football will know that French football also has a League Cup and a French equivalent of the FA Cup. So the League Cup is the equivalent and the first game in the League Cup for me was Montpellier. And I dispatched them 3-0. Oh, I really need that victor. He just
here's the cross. He heads it for goal. It's wonderful work from the
just to calm me down so I wasn't angry over the past couple of days. I was angry, but I wasn't as angry as I would have been had I not gotten the job done against Montpellier. Of course, since it was a cup game, it would have, if it ended a draw or a defeat, I'd be out of the tournament. And if it ended a draw, it would have gone to extra time and penalties if necessary.
That will be a throw for Marseille.
So,
Sana Diarra got on the ball in midfield.
And I was saying that I have
player in that part of the pitch.
I think I've isolated what the problem. Well, I've known since after that first game what the problem with the second team is. But I have decided who I hope will definitely come in and sort that problem. As you know, I have quite a bit of money with this Marseille team. And since I'm only gonna be here for one more transfer window, which is the January transfer window, I need the improvements, and I need them badly. Or I might be knocked out of the Europa League. He come the
useful block in those
knockout stages. So I have inquired about striker, and I don't care how much the team is looking for him. I should easily have enough to pay for him and for a second inside, and that will booster for the second team. And Rekic scores his first goal of the season. That was time to do it. I honestly thought he was gonna be offside, and I hit the ball. I shot the ball out of frustration. I was like, because I know you can't actually get booked for that. You know you should.
Clean tackle. And here comes the.
No, he was not offside, and it is 1-0 against Nens.
Work by Marseille to get the ball back. Gregory Van der Veel.
Van der Veel. Vanderweel. Referee gives the penalty, I was wondering. I mean, because that was clearly a foul. I don't know what this idiot was doing. I mean, takes Vanderweel out. Oh.
Penalty, I feel, is...
And if anything, he should have been booked for kicking the ball away after conceding the foul. Well, anyway, that doesn't matter. What does matter is that Çalhanoğlu buries it to make it 2-0. Thank you for the helping with the lead extension there, Nantes, or is it? I don't know how to pronounce these names. Are so hard to pronounce. These people, the guys in white. I mean, yellow. I'm the one in white. Ah, oh, God! Ah.
And he claims the cross. It was, well, nothing's ever straightforward.
I'm so confused.
He's not been challenged.
The team there are 2-0 down. I don't know how to pronounce their name. Although, to be honest, I'm probably not pronouncing my own team's name correctly. Let's see, I think I already played that game.
We're gonna study now, which is underway with Marseille leading.
I'm trying to remember how many games Saint Etienne, who are currently in second, well, last time I checked they were in second anyway. Could have changed since then for all I know.
Into the challenge, he made the block.
They were second last time I checked, and I can't remember. I think they might have played 11, and this is my 11th game. So, I think they have already played for this particular
substitution.
Their 11th game. So, yeah, I think my gap will be back to 5 points. As this, provided I win. I say provided I win as I'm 2-0 up. Well, that, you know, never know. You never count out any team.
Fixture is not. They'll be facing
or however you say their name.
Well, that's not even close.
Going up against the team I played in my last game, Montpellier.
About Marseille's next game.
Irony there for you. There's my next opponent, Lille.
I think it's going to be pretty easy.
November. That January transfer window is going to be here as soon as you think.
Referee's pointed for a goal kick.
Shawaii.
This might be it. That's great hands from the goalkeeper.
Straight to the hands of the keeper.
That's a turnover to the opposition.
Could do. I can channel ugly.
Gomez.
Yo, not giving up. Brilliant. Tovan! Ah, oh. Mendy! Freaking left back coming all the way up to have a crack. Not getting anything for his efforts.
It takes a nick off the player.
That's a throw. I don't know. Wait, what? That's my throw. It's stuck. Doing. Ooh. Idiots or no, that was almost the first goal I've conceded in this career mode.
Going to be a substitution here for the home side. Colbert. He's got a cross to make that interception. He saw it coming. Too eager to get in at goal as he would have been.
Oh, Enkidu is offside.
Good chance on there, and he just bolted out the traps too early.
It's out for a throw. I was trying to hit that forward, but my player decides they are off on the.
Put the ball out for a throw.
You fly outside. It's for a throw.
For a throw, he could have been a bit luckier
there. Can't prevent yet another throw. Okay, that one. That throw is going to be mine. Great ball. Oh, I thought I might get to Beshawai Bachalo, who's got it. Ah.
Breakaway did look dangerous. This is well, they've won the ball back.
Got his shot off now. Oh, the son of Diarra! Where did he pull that from? I mean, I didn't expect it to go in. He picks up the ball. Oh, I just have a crack. I'm like, you know, he might parry it, put it out for a corner. But no, he beats the goalkeeper. Wrapping up the 3 points in spectacular style. 3-0. Oh.
Well, we're in the last few minutes now, and the die has been cast in this game, really.
I think that went out.
Osvaldo Vizcarra.
3 points are wrapped up again.
In. Added minutes.
Another great performance, and that'll be a goal kick.
And he takes it on with a shot at goal.
Couldn't keep it down, but it's not gonna matter. 3 was a very good, decent scoreline, and there is the full-time whistle.
Ended it now.
Nanets, or however you say their name, is their beat. And yeah, solid victory.
Angers,
and I will have
Guingamp.
I have good
three. Troy. Two,
and I'm on great form heading into the next game against Lille.
Two, Lille 1. Stade Rennais 0, Paris Saint-Germain 1. Let's see what that means.
Yep, Saint-Étienne.
At the top of the table remain Olympique Marseille with 33 points. In second,
28 points. That puts them 5 behind me. How much will they want for him? 22.5 million, so there you see who I'm looking for, Ben Yedda. I haven't used him yet in this FIFA, but enjoy using him. I mean, other FIFAs, he's a very, he good striker. I kind of wish I could make a bid outside of the transfer window. Like, it's kind of annoying that I have to wait for the window to open to actually make an official bid. I mean, maybe that'll be one of the next things they add into the game. The ability to submit actual offers to teams in between, even when the window is closed. Because if you ask me, it'd be really handy for me to know Now, to a great degree with Italy's for Ben Yedder, negotiate a contract with him and have him set to come in on the 1st of January. Now, I mean, you can do that in real life. You can do that in real life. So, it's a logical next step if they want to make the game more realistic.
The defenders will be watching out for him. Top scorer in the league with 9.
This is the Lille lineup. Vincent Enyama starts in goal. Frank Beria starts with...
Anyway, that's neither here nor there. Or what is here is this game against Lille.
We'll see how.
Hopefully, 3 more points.
Olympic Marseille's lineup. Steve Mandanda starts in goal.
And the wheel. Oh, the deflection will lead to the corner. Still looking for his first goal in a Marseille shirt.
He's great, but his self-control is wonderful, rarely in trouble.
Yeah, he's
sure he would have loved it to be in there.
Sometimes you get
I don't think that,
that but
stayed in. No,
he's a very good player.
Happy
back up for him in this position.
Just from the fact that I couldn't control anyone
Benjamin
to pounce on the ball.
Obadi. Gregory van der Veel.
Fletcher.
Good play, one on one.
It's another corner. Toban doesn't win the header, or Enkidu won't get there. But the fast throw is on.
And they want to restart the game. You can understand that with the throw on it goes.
Diarra.
Good place to win the ball back there, because the pressure was starting to mount. And the interception was timely, to say the least. He's got a.
Thiago! Oh, another beauty! Hey. And Hakan Thiago scores his 9th of the season, which, if I'm not mistaken, puts him joint first in terms of goals scored with Ashawai. I think Fletcher has like 6,
giving the opposition a problem,
maybe
7.
So he's not completely out of the question yet. But the question may be back on.
Looking a problem until the clearance.
And Bashaw, hey, he hasn't even scored in a few games.
Florian Thauvin. Counter-attack could be over here.
This game is not over yet. Could be more goals in this.
Sebastian Corchia. Gregory van der Veel.
Thauvin can't keep it in. It's out for a goal kick.
Player's done well here until it was the direction of the pass, really. Right idea, but couldn't find his man. It's out over the touch.
Mendy.
Lassana Diarra.
Diarra.
A chance to move forward.
Sloppy pass. Gives it away. Thauvin will win it back.
Some work to do, because they've lost their last 2 games. They've got home advantage. They need to win today.
Oh, poor. Hold on. White man.
Well, the refs give
yellow card for the for.
Yeah, no surprise there at all.
Yeah, I was gonna say it was Corchina or something like that. If I had the right player. Game tells me that I do.
The referee's taken the right steps after the wall took the wrong steps.
Not sure why it's this guy on the wall.
Good work by the goalkeeper. He saw the free kick coming.
Chalago's free kick, not exactly the best, but yeah. Not on that occasion anyway. He definitely has the best free kicks in the team. Not sure why he wasn't taking that one. I'll have to check that. Fletcher, can you make it 2-0? Best away! Just as I said, he hasn't scored in a while. he comes up out of nowhere and scores. Yo, he's like, no one is sure on top goal scorer with me. It's another pretty easy goal for Bashawai, but they all count. They all count.
Starting at 2-0.
And it is 2-0.
Trying to stretch the opposition using the wider areas here.
Again, if you could see like a stat chart or some shit like that of how many goals I've scored in the first half and second half in this career mode so far, the chart would be one-sided in terms of the first half compared to the second half. I mean, good to get the goals nice and early, but it's just weird that the team seems to go quiet in the second half. Fletcher going for his name on the score sheet.
Martin.
Cleared. And there's the halftime whistle. Well, and her great performance in that half. Chalogu's just too tired to continue on in this match, unfortunately. This is not out of anything in particular, but Bashawai just has a smidge more stamina than Fletcher, which means Fletcher needs the break more than he does.
Talk about this lad, isn't it? And you can see why it's such an important part of a team, the attacking.
Just because these guys can come in handy.
Midfield jobs as well.
Next episode, when I have to try and qualify for the knockout stages of the Europa League.
Retains the energy and the.
All I need is one win.
Make a problem for himself going forward.
So,
Roma Alessandrini.
The performances haven't been good.
The break is definitely on. It's a real tussle between the two. And here's the shot. Terrific stop. And it's out.
Whew. That was almost sin.
But he clears the danger.
Van der Wiel. Oh, the deflection. Enkidu. Oh.
The referee stopped it for.
Oh, he was offside. It wouldn't have counted anyway for the. White man.
Be a throw for Marseille. Romain Alessandrini played down the wing, keeping the wide attack
as he
going.
Puts it out for a Lille throw. Sorry, no, it was Bashawai.
Terrific tackle.
Paying attention.
Great goalkeeping.
Oh, Campos.
You can only put it behind for the corner. And he goes for goal with his head. Great header.
Trying to get his name on the score sheet.
I thought he was going to score with a header, but top keeping.
Not working. It's Campos. Dongo.
He's hit it straight at the keeper. Not really what he wanted to do.
Rikic.
It's the league fixture.
Enkidu.
To just tell you about for the home team, that's their next game.
And the ball into the box. Unchallenged.
That's taken the heat.
Bashawai won't get a second stab at it. Leo cleared the ball. And apparently I committed a foul at some point there. Whoa! Don't do that again, okay? Mandela.
Obadi.
You know. Not a joking matter. Or I would like to keep a clean sheet if possible.
It's gone out of play there. Roma Alessandrini.
Alessandrini.
Van der Wiel.
Van der Wiel.
Shots on here.
Oh, there we go. Oh, finally. Greg Van Der Wiel gets exactly what he was. He's been looking for 12 games. And his first goal in a Marseille shirt.
Viewpoint on it.
Unlucky 13 is not unlucky for him. And the crowd,
now 3-0 they lead.
Oops, are going well for him. That's nice. I bet PSG, he might actually miss him at this point. Oh, no. Oh, no foul given against Batshuayi there. I was going to say, hey, that's not being given as a foul. Alessandrini, can he get a chance to cross it in?
Comes out with a punch to clear the danger.
Enkidu.
Now the shot!
Ah!
The flag was up for offside.
Oh, he was offside anyway. Didn't matter. Campos.
They put that cross far too close to the goalkeeper.
And Dungu just decides to randomly dive straight into the keeper, or for no particular reason.
It is very late in the day here. Well, when they do say, and you've been in these matches, about the psychology of getting it right on the big day, you would have thought ability-wise it's very much a level pegging here, but in fact, one side seems far more up for it than the other.
Yeah, I think that does seem to be the case. Whether the one manager has pumped up his players, got them ready better than his opposite number, that seems to be the case.
Shoei.
He's got his shot off now. Good play by the defenders, really.
He's completely spent.
The shot. It's a long way wide.
Yeah, he just lost his shape completely and made a real hash of that strike.
There's the full-time whistle. Oh, the job is done. Another 3-0 win. Another 3 points. Another clean sheet as well. I'm getting more of them.
Champions Cup. Borussia Mönchengladbach 1, Zenit 0. CSKA Moscow 2, Celtic 0. Manchester City 2, Lazio 1. Olympiacos 2, Paris Saint-Germain 0. Valencia 1, PSV 1. Liga 1, Bordeaux 3, Troyes 1. Lille 0.
So, in the next episode, I will have a crucial game in Europa League. And see, I've once again changed the second team. This is how it's going to look for that game. Yeah, I'm going with a different formation again.
With 26 points. In fourth,
trying to find something that works, but nothing is working.
In fifth, Bordeaux with 20.
And it's nothing down here. Nothing down here with the defense. It's the offense. It's not good enough. They're not scoring the goal. All I need them to score.
With 16 points.
Bottom of the table. We wouldn't be having this game.
With 7 points.
There's a show of the table, second bottom, of needing Sampdoria to beat Krasnodar. Even if I beat Gothenburg, it might not be enough. I need Sampdoria not to lose against Krasnodar. A draw might not be good enough either. Or hang on, is there goal difference? Yeah, I need them to beat Krasnodar. Luckily, they've already done that, so should be no problem. Okay, Sampdoria, just beat Krasnodar again, and job done. We're both through. We'll focus on the next stage of the Europa League. So, in this episode, I will have that game against Gothenburg, and a game against Nice before that all-important game. Look at that one. There we go. The all-important in the game against Saint-Étienne on November 21st. But unfortunately, I can't play that game for a whole goddamn week. No, wait. I almost forgot Wednesday. It's so hard to get used to this new schedule. Oh, but I will. Bray, you with me? So in the next we'll take on Gothenburg in the Europa League. Hopefully get through. And I will face Nice in the league. But for this episode, I am going to say thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.